that glitters is not gold is a proverb never truer than in the resort strung along Spain's Costa Dorada, the Golden Coast, which can at times appear to be tourism's equivalent of factory farming. This hand-carved gem of a resort was popular long before the current package explosion. Sitges has always jealously guarded its personality, noting the way many of its rivals have torn themselves apart to make room for more high-rise hotels and apartment blocks. It gets pretty crowded in high season, and they haven't solved the problem of the traffic, which crawls in ever-increasing circles along the promenade, as far as the steps which lead to the parish church. The church of St. Thecla and St. Bartholomew dates back to the 10th century, nearly 1,000 years before this bizarre little palace perched behind it, which was designed for a wealthy Chicago businessman by the famous post-impressionist artist Miguel Utrillo. For some reason, Utrillo combined the English Gothic style at its most austere and grotesque with Catalan mosaics. He added a menacing menagerie of gargoyles and then stuffed the interior with hundreds of priceless antiques rummaged from every corner of the earth. But his master plan didn't come off, and the finished product is now described by the rather embarrassed locals as imagination run riot. Next door, better taste got the upper hand with the museum, which contains works by famous artists like El Greco, Picasso, and one of Europe's most important collections of genuine forged iron, if you see what I mean. These self-service apartments have 3 double bedrooms, lounge, kitchen and bathroom, and enjoy the amenities of 2 swimming pools, one for the children, who also have their own playground, a restaurant, 2 beaches, and a marina expanding to accommodate 600 small boats. You may decide to buy one so you can drop in at any time of the year. And if it's one like this that tickles your fancy, make sure you've got £14,500 on hand when you pop along to sign the deeds. It would cost you considerably more than that to buy this particular example of bric-a-brac, even if it's still for sale. It's an apartment hotel, built on a hill overlooking Sitges, which somehow didn't catch on as quickly as the owners had hoped, in spite of the commanding view of the town from its battlements. Perhaps they should have gone into the wine trade instead, which has brought prosperity to Villa Franca, 12 miles down the well-labelled road, ever since the Romans transplanted their vines here 2,000 years ago, although the local inhabitants had started the grapes rolling centuries before that. The closest thing I've seen to an outdoor hotel is La Ballena Alegre, 8 miles from Sitges. It's the biggest camping site in Europe and a favourite with the French, German, Dutch and the Spanish themselves. And even if it sometimes seems that they're all here at once, the camp's capacity is just 8,000, give or take a few hundred. With a charge for your car, tent or trailer, the total cost for a family of 4 comes out about £1.60 a night. Simple bungalows for 2 can be had for about the same amount. The camp is open all the year round, although the restaurant with its international menu, including fish or steak and chips for about 60 pence, closes from November till March. And for the rest of the year, the sun shines hot and brightly on the half-mile-long beach shared with 4 other major sites. Meanwhile, under the shade of the pine trees, life goes on, like in a small town. Everything is kept clean by resident chars and mosquito-free with daily spraying of insecticide. Should one get you anyway, or if you fall ill or injured, there's a resident nurse and a doctor holds a daily surgery. It's all highly organised, but, and you'll pardon me if I state the obvious, if you like some peace and privacy, try somewhere else. Solitude is an attraction lost long ago along most of this stretch of the Costa Dorada. I suppose if you want the sea and the sun at a reasonable price these days, you just have to be prepared to share them with a lot of others. So I think I'll get a bit of practice in here before I go on the road. Por favor, Manuel.
Sí. Gracias.